Hi guys, and welcome back in MedicalScribe. In this video, we will talk about the terms of movement. As we know in the previous videos, that anatomical terms is divided into three main types. And we explained the first type, which is the terms of relationship and comparison. Then we explained the terms of laterality. And today we have the terms of movement that describe the body movement or a specific structure movement with these terms, which is in fact a lot of terms, like flexion and extension, abduction and adduction, and rotation, and others, which we will explain them with all its details in the upcoming videos. And we will illustrate them as an opposing pairs, thus mean the term and its opposite. Or what will this term describe, and what will the opposite describe on the other hand, in order to understand them easier and memorize them better. In general, most of movement that the human body do are complementary relationship in nature, that's combined between the anatomical position and according to specific axes and to specific plane to the structure. This occurs in order to perform this movement efficiently. And this complementary relationship mostly seen in the joints. And the joint is the site where two bones or more are articulate. But not all these joints move. No, because it also subdivided into types and division. And in a hurry and as information for you, the joints divided regarding its mobility into three types, which are the joints that have no movement, like the sutures of the skull, and to the joints that have a slight movement, like the superior tibiofibular joint, which is the joint that found in the superior aspect between the tibia and the fibula of the leg, and to the joints that are freely movable, like the shoulder joint. So this is the type of joints in brief. Now let's move forward and arrange what we said. We say that the complementary relationship that combine between the anatomical position and the axis and the anatomical plane of structure mostly seen in the joints. But the thing that we don't pay attention to is that not only the joints can move. There are structures other than the joints can move also. And they need the same complementary relationship, like we have the tongue, or we have the lips, or the eyelids, or we have the hyoid bone, which is the bone that's found in the neck. So all these structures will move, and according to the complementary relationship that is essential to perform their movement well. So that was a brief explanation about the terms of movement, and we will explain the terms of this group in the upcoming videos. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.